This is the seventh in a series called Black Adventist Women You Should Know, highlighting 28 extraordinary Black Adventist women for Black History Month. At blacksdahistory.org, everything is free, but we do ask you to donate, if you can, on the PayPal link in the video description below. J. Estelle Barnett was born in Mississippi in 1895, and from her humble beginnings as a Black woman in the poorest state in the nation, she resolved that in her life, she would help the have-nots. After graduating from Oakwood, she moved to Zanesville, Ohio, where she immediately saw the need for a safe place for Black youth to be educated and to play. Barnett raised the money and support to found the Zanesville Civic League Community Center in 1919, which is still in operation today, more than a century later. Next, she moved to Cincinnati, a city where thousands of Blacks were migrating to from the South for a better life. Many of these were struggling in the new urban environment, and Barnett helped them in her role as the executive secretary of the Young Women's Christian Association, YWCA, and as a social worker for the City Welfare Department. She also held a leadership position in the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, NAACP. From 1946 to 1963, Barnett was the founder and president of the Christian Benefit Association, or CBA, a nonprofit that helped people financially meet life's crises like car accidents, personal injuries, and family deaths when they did not have insurance or were denied coverage. The CBA also provided scholarships for young people to receive a Christian education. The association's motto was based on Romans 15:1, "We then that are strong ought to bear the infirmities of the weak." Barnett also aimed her efforts to help the disadvantaged in her church. When Lucy Byard, a Black senior citizen dying from liver cancer, was refused admission into the Washington Avenue Sanitarium because she was Black, Barnett joined other concerned Black lay people to form the Committee for the Advancement of the Worldwide Work Among Colored Seventh-day Adventists in 1944. The committee released an influential pamphlet, "Shall the Four Freedoms Function Among Seventh-day Adventists," which protested the racial injustices in the Adventist Church and demanded systematic reforms. The committee also personally contacted church leaders, including the General Conference president, calling on them to address the untenable racial situation in the church. Barnett was one of the key organizers of the Ohio branch of Black Adventist laity who rallied for justice in the Columbia Union. Her efforts should be seen as integral to the church's decision to implement regional or Black-operated conferences, although she and other Black people, Black Adventist lay people, were calling for unity, not separation. And white Adventists opted for separate conferences because they did not want to be integrated with Black people. Almost 20 years later, in 1962, Barnett was a mover in the Layman's Leadership Council, LLC, a grassroots Black Adventist organization that protested racial discrimination in the form of racial quotas and exclusion in Adventist churches, schools, hospitals, and workplaces. A number of changes came from the LLC's protest, most prominently the election of the church's first Black vice president, Frank L. Peterson, at the 1962 General Conference in San Francisco. But from the 1943 committee and the LLC came more subtle but permanent changes, such as Blacks being allowed to enroll in church schools and hospitals, Blacks being allowed to enroll in church schools and hospitals at a higher rate, Blacks being hired in denominational employ and having better working conditions, and other basic, humanly decent things a church should do. Barnett left her church and her world a better, more just place.